GENEPAULACEPETER here, just with a small quick pickup. I had a couple of first appearances on my list to get, and so I went ahead and got them. This is Captain America number 180. Captain America and the Falcon. Captain America 180. Anyway, this is the first appearance of Nomad. And not the Jack Monroe one, but this is Cap as Nomad. So I've been looking for that. I've been looking for some first appearances of some of the minor superheroes. So I was glad to get that one. This is Daredevil number 150. Got a small stamp up here and stamp here for 49¢. But other than that, it's in really great shape. Daredevil 150. This is the first appearance of Paladin. Great cover. And this is 212, The Amazing Spider-Man, the first appearance of Hydro Man. This one I've been wanting a while, but like I said about the Speedball one, the price has always just been a little too not what I wanted to pay for it. But the price was right on this one. And so yeah, the first appearance of Hydro Man. And the last two, I got multiple copies of, because I love this cover. But not only that, I had just recently watched the new Iron Man show, Armored Adventures. I'm sure some of you are watching that. And Ghost is making a real big appearance in it. Because of the armor wars that's going on in the show. Anyway, this is the first appearance of Ghost, and I picked up two copies of it. This copy, this book here, you can get really affordable. It's really cheap. It's anywhere between a $3 to $6 book, depending where you buy it. But it's definitely a first appearance book that's worth getting to have in your collection, I think. Artwork by Bob Layton. I was never a fan of the red and white armor that Iron Man had during the 80s. It just wasn't my thing. I prefer the gold and red. But yeah, both in really high grade condition. Really sharp corners. Bright white. So yeah, just a real short video today. I'm going to try and get out and get some more books. I just haven't really had the cash or the time. I'm still selling a lot of my books. Trying to narrow down the my collection. I'm trying to sell the majority of what's here, for example. So there's a lot of stuff here. All this stuff I'm basically getting rid of. A lot of DC stuff that I'm getting rid of. So if there is something you had in mind that you wanted to buy, oh, and then I'm getting rid of some of the, excuse me for a sec. Other ones I'm selling are, you know, I've got two copies of First Appearance of Jubilee. I'm selling the First Appearance of Wolverine. Wolverine number one. This is the first appearance cameo of Gambit. Basically selling like the majority of my X-Men book. 211. That's the first appearance of the Marauders. That's the first appearance of Green Goblin 3. Amazing Spider-Man 200. Secret Wars number 8. The entire run. Oh, the entire run of the Wolverine miniseries I got for sale. And all books are in all high grade. If you have a question about any books, just let me know. The more books you buy off me, the cheaper I can knock the prices down. Off the bat, I graded and priced the comics according to the Overstreet price guide, but even if you're only buying the single issue, I'm probably going to do 25% below the guide value. So, you know, if you buy more, I mean, I can give you a really good deal, basically. What else we got here? Lots of X-Men, the whole Dark Phoenix saga I'm trying to sell. What else? Real high grade copy of Wolverine number 10, first appearance or first fight between Sabretooth and Wolverine. Marvel feature, first solo issue of The Thing, number 11. Selling that. There's a great little box. It fits everything perfect. There's the other copy I have of that. Wolverine number 1 again. And Teenage Ninja Turtles, first print, number 5. Like I said, all these are in really high grade condition. If you're serious about buying any of these books, just PM me. I'm not looking to break the bank on these. I'm just really trying to save up some money. So yeah, if you're interested in any of these books, just PM me. That, like I said, the more you buy, the cheaper I can mark the prices. And all these X-Men, all these early, or all these Bronze Age books. That's a great cover there. I can give you a really good price on it. Like this one here, 136. The Uncanny X-Men. Oh, sorry, I'm looking at it. Yeah, I have that as a 9.4 to 9.6, but I would say that's even probably a 9.0. I can do it for, you know, probably 30 bucks or something. I don't know. I have to look again. But the whole series of the Wolverine, I could probably do for 125 maybe. These are all in high grade condition, and they're all the 60 cent variants except for this one, the 75 cent variant to go along. But if you did buy the whole set, I would throw in this one for free with it. So you're basically getting issue 2 for free. Great book here. This one, for example, I have listed as $20. So 20 bucks. First appearance of Symbiote Suit, you can't go wrong. This one's in a very high grade as well, and I have that marked as 40, but again, I can do better on all these books. 25. Hey, that's a mark. So guess it's free. $15. Now, the Incredible Hulk one, I don't want to disclose any price over there. The best I can tell you about it is that it's in a really high grade. Like, there's, you can count the stress marks. As I was saying, yeah, you can count literally on your hand the amount of stress marks that are on the spine. There's near to none. The corners are sharp. The colors are good. The big downfall is that the Marvel stamp inside is missing, and I can show you that right now. Just one moment. So yeah, here's the inside of the page. I mean, it is tight and it looks good. I'm gonna lay this down for 1 second just so I can find the Marvel stamp to show you. And unfortunately, hey, actually it's different than I thought. I remembered. I'm gonna put this underneath. just to show you. This is the damage of the missing marble stamp. It wasn't cut out perfectly. That's about how far it should be, so it's about twice as long as wide as it should be. Other than that, which most people who know, who either have a copy of this book, know that it doesn't affect the story, but it does affect the grade, and it does affect the value. But other than that, I'm gonna get it nice and close. So other than that, I mean, it is in great shape. So what I propose is that all these books here, I want to sell them. So the way I'll do it, if you can find a cheaper copy, or if you find a value, say on eBay for this one, and somebody's selling it for $20, I can do better. If they're selling this one for $45, I can do better. You know what I mean? Most of these books, if they're selling it for cheaper, or selling them at a price that the cheapest you can find, this one you can find, let's say, for $20. I could do it for $15. You have to send me the URL or the link to it so I can just check it out myself. Just compare grades and prices for myself, and, you know, not out here to rip anybody off. I'm just trying to really gotta pull some money together. So yeah, if you have any questions, PM me. If you like any of the issues, I can run through them again one more time. That's the Incredible Hulk 181, X-Men Annual 14, Uncanny X-Men 211, Wolverine number 1, Uncanny X-Men 244, Amazing Spider-Man 176, Amazing Spider-Man 200, Marvel Secret Wars number 8, Wolverine number 3, the miniseries, Wolverine number 2, the miniseries, the 75-cent variant, Wolverine number 2, the 60-cent variant, and Wolverine number 1, Wolverine number 4, Uncanny X-Men 136, Uncanny X-Men 135, Uncanny X-Men 134, Uncanny X-Men 133, Uncanny X-Men 132, Uncanny X-Men 112, now this one's in a low grade, but 137, it's a good grade. This one's also in a low grade, 138, but I do have a high grade copy of it, 138, very high grade copy of Wolverine number 10, Marvel Feature number 11, another copy of Uncanny X-Men number 211, another copy of Wolverine number 1, and Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles number 5. Okay, well, I also have a lot of other books. I'm gonna putting up some books, see if we can get some bites on these first, because I'm not a real X-Men fan. Okay. This video is running longer than I expected. GenePaulACePeter signing out.